Probably heard of Squid Game. Oh, by the way, don't bother with Squid Game The Challenge on Netflix. It's terrible. Squid Game is part of a vibrant drama and film scene in Korea. In the United States, dramas are either formulaic, that's why there are 7,000 CSIs and 2,000 FBIs and 3,000 911s and otherwise game shows. American television is mostly just concerned with not offending anyone, and so they've kind of forgotten how to entertain. So I'm going to show you three shows from Korea that I think are worth checking out. I think they're entertaining and thought-provoking. Well, a couple of them are thought-provoking, but always entertaining. First one is Black Knight. It's based on a web action series. The hero is 5'8", whose name is otherwise unknown, a delivery man in a post-apocalyptic wasteland in Korea. Everything is covered in dust, which may or may not be radioactive. In general, the air is not breathable outside without a special mask, and everybody lives in essentially little boxes. 5'8 is the delivery man, sort of like a UPS, who bring food and oxygen and devices to people who live in these tiny little boxes, which are safe. In the tiny boxes, you're safe as long as you have regular deliveries of oxygen. And outside is a fairly dangerous place because outside are groups of thieves who will try and knock over these delivery trucks for the stuff that's inside them. So 5'8 has to not only drive but defend his vehicle. And that's where it starts to get really violent. 5'8 happens across a young man who wants to be a delivery man himself. 5'8 will mentor him through his training and toughness. As the series progresses, we learn more about the delivery man's origins, who the bad guys we see are really working for, and why they do what they do, and how can they be defeated. So there's an understory, which is the young man, and an overstory, which is the society as a whole. Again, the show is very violent, a lot of gunplay, a lot of fighting. I didn't get overwhelmed by it, but probably not for kids. It's one of those adult shows. Second show is Flex X Cop. Now, flex is a term in Korean that is equivalent to a profligate spender, a young man who's a silver spoon in his mouth without responsibilities and just has a good time with daddy's money. By the way, I apologize in advance if I mispronounce names because I'm American. So the central character is a guy named Jin Isu, who is the second son of the chairman of one of these huge Korean conglomerates, a huge conglomerate with many products. By various machinations, which I won't go into, he becomes a policeman, an actual policeman, at the local violent crimes division. Just go with it. This might sound a lot like Castle, which I suspect it is intended to be, but the characters are all very different personalities from the ones in Castle. Since Jin Isu is a actual policeman, the dynamics are different. As the show goes on, Jin Isu becomes more and more to identify himself as a cop, rather than just a rich dilettante. The first six or so episodes are mostly just light comedy kind of things. I mean, light comedy around murders. So they have a murder to solve, but the interaction of the characters as you get to know them is fairly flippant and sort of like Castle. So the first six episodes are kind of like that. As we get to know more about the backstory of Jin Isu and how it is almost entirely not what he thinks, getting very much darker. And not only him, but the boss at the police station has a hand in this, and his father has a hand in this. And we get to know everybody and why they do what they do. Very important, not just these stone bad guys, we get to know why the other characters do what they do, including the policemen. We get to know them too. As far as the murders go, they're good mysteries. The clues are given in proper order and in reasonable time. The flow of the show is good. The cases take usually two episodes, or maybe a little bit more, a little bit less, to solve. So they don't just feel like, you know, slam bang, here we are. The final case, I was very impressed with because I got everything wrong. Presented with all the clues, I was wrong twice as to what had happened and who was who and what was what.
만약에 다른 배가 있었다면
그러니까 새벽 1시에 우연히 지나가던 배가 정인아 씨를 구하고 죽였다는 거야?
우연인지 아닌지는 모르지. 근데 누군가가 정인아 씨를 구한 건 확실해.
So a very entertaining show. I liked it a lot. Flex X Cop is streaming on Hulu and Disney Plus. The third show is the one that is, to me, most interesting. It's something of a fantasy. It's got a lot of really dark themes. It's called Tomorrow. Choi Jun-wei is the central character. He is a young man, just out of school, and he's looking for a job, and he's failing miserably.
일찍 일어나도 좋고, 새벽 축구 안 봐도 좋고, 매일매일이 월요일이어도 괜찮으니까, 나도 사원증 갖고 싶다. 아, 나 진짜 너무너무 자소서 쓰기 힘들다.
And he's failing so often that he's just giving up. So completely depressed, he walks to a bridge over the Han River in Seoul and is probably going to kill himself, just throw himself into the river. While he's there, he sees another man who is also about to do this. And Choi decides he's going to stop him. For whatever reason, he loses track of what he was here to do and goes to save this other man. While he's doing this, two more characters appear, a man and a woman, who appear to have some kind of supernatural powers. They save Choi from killing himself and recruit him into their group of what turn out to be angels. Now he's not dead. He's a human. He's in a coma in a hospital, but he's still human. He's still himself. So they recruit him into their organization. They are what are called Grim Reapers, although they don't actually do what we would call Grim Reaper stuff. They're part of a larger Grim Reaper organization. And they are known as the risk management team. Their job is to stop people who are trying to kill themselves. So here we go into a very dark issue, a very dark theme, which is for the rest of the series. And that's suicide. And they don't shy away from it. I mean, suicide is, as one character says, the most selfish action you can take. It's giving up on not only yourself, but everybody you know. It's profoundly selfish. And this show faces this issue head on. And I mean, they don't pull any punches. Most of the shows take two episodes to tell all the way through and allows us to meet the suicide and begin to learn why they're doing what they're doing. Why have they reached the level of such despair? such just black despair that they cannot see themselves living until tomorrow. And the risk management team is there to try and convince them, not to just stop them, but convince them that this is a bad thing to do.
네가 너무 나약해 빠져서 싸울 용기도 의지도 없지. 만만하니까 괴롭히는 거야. 만만하니까. 너 자체가 민폐 덩어리야. 어쩌라고. 그래서 나보고 어쩌라고. 당신이 울었다고 나한테 그런 소리를 벗어나려고, 잘 살아보려고. 얼마나 내가 말모듬 쳤는데. 나는요, 웃는 것조차 상처여서 다시 웃으려고 얼마나 내가 했었는데 어떻게 내가 버텼는지 당신이 알기나 해. 근데 안 된다고. 그래? 그럼 다시 한번 물을게. 그래서 죽으면 다 끝날 것 같니?
That there's more to life than what they're doing, that there is a tomorrow to be looked forward to. So as we learn about these characters, these suicides, we see their backstory. We see what's causing them this terrible, terrible despair. These are not happy stories. I mean, this despair is entirely warranted. They have been either mistreated by others, they've been mistreated by life, they are just overwhelmed with long-standing grief. Whatever it is, they are just done. The risk management team is there to try and convince them that this is a bad thing. So the show lays bare all this the logic that goes on inside a person who wants to kill themselves, who decides that this is the appropriate end. The characters are not happy. The risk management team is not happy. Joy is not happy. The people they try and save are not happy. And even when they're saved, it's not their lives are turned around and, you know, haha, happy ending. No. All that happens is that they find that reason to go on to tomorrow. So it's not a happy story. Even when it ends, it's not a happy story. So this is as dramatic as you can get. And it's well written, well acted by everybody, well directed. It's just well worth your time. And who could ask for more from a television drama? So I recommend all three of these shows. They all have interesting stories. They all have interesting characters. They're all far better, in my opinion, than what you can see on television in this country these days. So give them a try. Tomorrow is available on Netflix. Bye-bye.
회장, 회장, 회장.
왔네, 천태영. DN 스튜디오 대표. 천태준, DM 미디어 부회장. 별명이 모델킬러.
내 아들 잡아간 년이 누구야? 니들 내가 누군지 알아?
오, 천 회장 두 번째 부인 이수민, DN 광고 대표. 마담 출신이야? 천 회장 첫 번째 부인 최연주.
천박하게 굴지 말고 채통 좀 지키시지.
DN 방송 대표.